live from South Padre Island, Texas. And here it is. This is the fateful piece of paper that has the names of our final three contestants on it. First of all, ladies, you have all represented your states beautifully over the past year. And yourselves this evening, you should be very proud. But we can only name three women to continue, and I will read these names in random order. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, the final three. First off is Miss South Carolina, Lou Parker. Next is Miss Virginia, Pat Southall. One more woman has a chance to become Miss USA, and she is Miss North Carolina, Lynn Jenkins. Ladies and gentlemen, one of these three beautiful young women will be the new Miss USA.
I think I lost my touch.
Okay, it's high tension time. The final question for these three.
This is crucial because even though the judges make their final decision based on everything the contestants have done this evening, this question can tip the balance if it's a close call.
And by the way, you won't see any scores here, so you're on your own trying to pick the winner. And you know what? I think it's happening, so why don't we go back to the stage?
All right, ladies, this is it, the last round of competition. This is the final question. Now, I'm going to ask each of you the same question. You'll each have 20 seconds in which to answer, and to make sure that the second and third contestants don't hear the question to the first contestant, we're going to put Virginia and North Carolina back in that soundproof booth back there. So if you would go ahead, go on back there, and Lou Parker, if you would come over here with me, Miss South Carolina. Come on, get on in there, gals. I know it's noisy, but you have to go in there. All right, can you hear us? Can you hear it? You can't hear a thing? Yeah, right. Okay. No, they can't. Trust me. Now I'm going to begin by asking you the question, Miss South Carolina. Here it is. The Winter Olympic Games begin tomorrow. Do you think an athlete who has been linked to but not arrested for a crime should be allowed to represent the United States?
I think that anyone is innocent before they are proven guilty. So I think that Tanya should be able to participate. She hasn't been committed of a crime. She has come to the public and said that she has not done anything wrong, that her husband did the crime. And I think that she should be able to compete. She's a teammate, and she'll do really well.
All right. That's Miss South Carolina. If you'd step right over here, please. And we bring out Miss Virginia. All right, Pat, the question is this. The Winter Olympic Games begin tomorrow. Do you think an athlete who has been linked to but not arrested for a crime should be allowed to represent the United States?
First of all, I think it comes to a judgment of judicial or ethical concerns. And my concern with Tanya Harding is that it's an ethical concern. She is not guilty because she hasn't been proven guilty. However, she misled our public. And I think representing yourself or our country in the Olympics is something that's important and it's precious, just like being here representing your state. And I think it's important to have great values and morals and to be sincere and to be honest with everyone. So I really don't think anyone should be able to represent our country unless they've been honest.
All right, Miss Virginia, if you would please take a spot over there. We bring out Miss North Carolina, Lynn Jenkins. Lynn, the question is this. The Winter Olympic Games begin tomorrow. Do you think an athlete who's been linked to but not arrested for a crime should be allowed to represent the United States?
Well, I think that being the Olympics is a tremendous honor. But I also think that everyone has the right to their innocence. And what a shame it would be if that person were not able to compete and win with what they have every right to win. But at the same time, if they have been found guilty of the charge, I think they should be publicly stripped of everything they've won because they certainly didn't deserve it.
All right, there is Miss North Carolina. Thank you very much, ladies. Now it's time for the final vote to determine who the new Miss USA will be. As each contestant steps forward, the judges will consider their overall impression of her in the competition this evening, and they will rank each young lady as they vote for her to be the second runner-up, the first runner-up, or the new Miss USA. And we begin with Miss South Carolina. Miss Virginia. And Miss North Carolina. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes our competition for the title of Miss USA 1994.
Oh my goodness, I am so nervous with that music. Ba-boom.
Did you see the judges, the audience reaction at that question?
Advanced. It's really hard. Yeah. Really hard.